श्रीमद्भागवतम कैंटो फोर चैप्टर फोर टेक्स्ट नंबर सिक्स ब्रह्मघोषोर्जित यज्ञवैश्यसम विप्रसीजिष्ठम विबुधश्च सर्वशः मृद्धार्व अयह कांचन दर्भचर्मभिर् निःसृष्टभाण्डं यजनं समाविशात्. Translation purported by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. She then reached her father's house, where the sacrifice was being performed, and entered the arena, where everyone was chanting the Vedic hymns. The great sages, brahmanas, demigods were all assembled there, and there were many sacrificial animals as well as pots made of clay, gold, stone, gold, grass, skin, which were all requisite for the sacrifice. Purport. When learned sages and brahmanas assembled to chant Vedic mantras, some of them also engage in arguing about the conclusion of the scriptures. Thus, some of the sages and brahmanas were arguing and some of them were chanting the Vedic mantras. So the entire atmosphere was surcharged with transcendental sound vibration. This transcendental sound vibration has been simplified in the transcendental vibration Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. In this age, no one is expected to be highly educated in the Vedic ways of understanding, because people are very slow, lazy, and unfortunate. Therefore, Lord Chaitanya has recommended the sound vibration of Hare Krishna, and in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is also recommended. Yajnai sankirtanai praye rejantihi sumeja saha. At the present moment, it is impossible to gather sacrificial necessities because of the poverty of the population and their lack of knowledge in Vedic mantras. Therefore, for this age, it is recommended that people gather together and chant the Hare Krishna mantra to satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is accompanied by His associates. Indirectly, this indicates Lord Chaitanya, who is accompanied by His associates, Nityananda, Advaita and others. This is a process of performing yajna in this sacrifice. Another significant point in this verse is that there were animals for sacrifice. These animals were meant for sacrifice does not mean that they were meant to be killed. The great sages and realized souls assembled were performing yajnas, and their realization was tested by animal sacrifice. Just as in modern science, tests are made on animals to determine the effectiveness of a particular medicine. The brahmanas entrusted with the performance of yajna were very self-realized, and to test their realization, an old animal was offered in fire and rejuvenated. That was the test of a Vedic mantra. The animals gathered were not meant to be killed and eaten. The real purpose of a sacrifice was not to replace a slaughterhouse, but to test a Vedic mantra by giving an animal new life. Animals were used to test the power of Vedic mantras and not for meat. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta purport. So, once she reached there, she saw that there were elaborate arrangements for the sacrifice, and great sages, the brahmanas, demigods, they all have assembled there, and also all the ingredients for the sacrifice, plus there were certain animals also for meant for sacrifice. And she saw that the brahmanas, sages, they were all chanting the mantras, and the entire atmosphere was surcharged with transcendental vibration. And Prabhupada explains there, and that's where she enters the sacrificial arena. Prabhupada says that all these mantras are actually compressed in the Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Normally, so many Vedic mantras are there for different purposes. to be chanted by different people for different kinds of effect in human society. So all these things were compressed, Prabhupada explains here. In the Bhagavatam it says that the yajna in Kali Yuga is Sankirtana yajna. So all these are different kinds of yajnas. A human being, a civilized human being, has to perform different kinds of yajnas in his life, in his daily routine and in his life. A family man or a single man or different individuals within the Varnashrama society, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, they are all supposed to, even Shudra is supposed to take part, though not perform. So various kind of yajnas were being is part of the duty or very much existent in a model Vedic Varnashrama society. Now all these things are no longer in proper order in Kali Yuga. The society itself is not in proper order. There is no social system as prescribed in the Vedas today. Everything is almost like a polished human life. It's almost like a polished animal life. Even if somebody is interested in following all these things, it is not possible to follow all these things. Because one cannot accumulate all the necessary ingredients for such yajna, nor do they get the proper brahmanas to chant these mantras. So therefore, this is out of question to do this standard kind of Vedic yajnas in this yuga, in this Kali Yuga. Therefore, Bhagavatam has revealed the secret that Krishna Varnam Tusha Krishnam Sango Pangastra Parshadam Yajnai Sankirtana Prayer Yajanti Hi Sumedashaha. As Prabhupada is saying here, that indirectly this indicates Lord Chaitanya. Why? Krishna Varnam Tusha Krishna. Akrishna is non-blackish color. Sango Panga Shaparshadam. That means he is accompanied by all his associates, like Lord Nityananda, Advaita, and all. And Yajnai Sankirtane Prayer, they are engaged in Sankirtana Yajna. And they are pleased by Sankirtana Yajna is meant to please Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda. And this Yajna contains all other Yajna. This mantra contains all other mantras. It is a special, because it's Krishna's name. Just like when Krishna came 5,000 years back, it is described that all the scheduled incarnations were also within his body. That means all the scheduled incarnations, Vishnu, Chirodaksha Vishnu, Garbhodaksha, all of them are within him. Not only that, even the Virat Rupa, the form of the material universe, form and substance of the material universe, which includes all our bodies and all demigods, every bodies and everything in existence, that is called Virat Rupa. If you take the entire universe is the Virat Rupa of the Super Soul. The Super Soul is the soul of this universe. So even that was also in the scheduled incarnation. When Mother Yashoda asked Krishna to open his mouth to check if he has eaten mud, she saw the entire universal form inside his mouth. So even everything in existence is in Krishna's body. Now the same thing, everything in existence is also in Krishna's name. All mantras are in Krishna's name. All yajnas are within Sankirtana yajna. All japas are within Krishna Nama japa. In other words, if you do japa, if you do Sankirtana, if you do deity worship, etc., etc., all the different things centered around Krishna, then in Kali Yuga, that is the only thing that is possible. Possible means most effective. All other things are not required to be done at all. Material world itself is in a topsy-turvy situation, upside down. Therefore, people do not have peace. And as time goes by, people's life becomes so much interconnected and so complicated that they will not have any peace. Life itself becomes so fast. People have no time for themselves. They're completely running behind existence in this material world. How to exist? How to eat? How to sleep? Because even sleep you won't get. This age you can see in this, even in modern times we see sleep is a big problem for everybody. It is one of their primary necessities, eating, sleeping, mating, defending. He may have a very big salary, but he is not, with that salary, he is not able to sleep properly. He may have very big business, but with that he is not able to meet one of his basic material necessities. So even material necessities people are not able to meet, and therefore they become very frustrated. Because they are short-circuiting the Vedic way of life, the short-circuiting the way of human life. Might as well become animal, because in animal all these niceties are not there. So this is the way the Vaishnavas, from the point of view of Bhagavatam, the beginning of, sees the world, the devotees of Srimad Bhagavatam, see the world as the beginning of Kali Yuga. All principles of dharma are the normal, what is normal material life itself is not available for the living entity. So Krishna, being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he compensates for all this. And Lord Chaitanya, who appears after Lord Krishna, mercifully distributes this mercy of Hare Krishna Mahamantra for a small period. Then Kali Yuga will go full speed. We guess that is 10,000 years. Because Prabhupada said 10,000 years, this Sankirtana will influence in this material world. So rest of the time, of course, always Krishna Nama is there in Kali Kale, Krishna Nama Rupa Avatara. But in this particular period, in the beginning of the Kali Yuga, like inaugurated by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then recently inaugurated by Srila Prabhupada all over the world, this Krishna Nama Sankirtana is actually creating, is transforming thousands and thousands of people to become Krishna conscious, to change their lifestyle. Normally for somebody who is in Tamoguna to come to Sattoguna or even give up all the bad habits, it is very difficult. It is very, very difficult. Through the Vedic process itself is very difficult. Gradual evolution. But you see, miraculously, in this Krishna consciousness movement, we come in touch with Prabhupada, and so quickly we have a change in our consciousness. So much so that we don't want to associate with our old consciousness. That itself shows. There's clearly an old consciousness and a new consciousness. And we don't want to associate with the old consciousness. That means the new consciousness is of a higher taste than the low consciousness. This kind of consciousness replacement itself is the evidence of the power of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Because we are experiencing it, we take it for granted. But people don't transform in the outside world so fast. In any aspect, even materially also, they don't transform so fast. They are what they are. Their learning is very, very slow. So we, not a question of learning, we were dipped in something else before and we are taken out and dipped in something else. We are dipped in the Sankirtana, dipped in the holy name, in the Vaishnava association. It's completely a different experience is what can never be achieved by any gradual process of Vedic elevation. Following the Karma Kanda, following the Jnana Kanda of the Vedas, or even the Upasana Kandas of the Vedas, worshipping various demigods, all these things. It will not take us anywhere near the effect of beginning to chant Hare Krishna. The living entity does a huge jump in his consciousness. There are 84 lakh species of life. Out of that, 4 lakh species of human consciousness. Tamoguna to Sattuguna. And just by chanting Hare Krishna, the devotee rises up to the top level of the 4,000. 4,000 also are like demigods. But actually devotees go beyond demigod also. In the sense, even ordinary devotees, even a devotee who is 6 months also in his court, goes beyond the demigods. But he may not be able to remain there for long. So he is up and down he goes. But he has got a glimpse of, even one day if he attend full absorption in sadhana and sankirtana, he will feel beyond the demigods. And then again he will fall down. Because it's a sudden jump. He may fall down to the lowest of 4,000 also. But again he will chant Hare Krishna. Next day, again he will chant Hare Krishna. It will lift him beyond 4,000. Consciousness goes like that. But by continuous association with the holy name, one should understand. Sometimes devotees feel very depressed. Prabhu, I am not able to be steady in Krishna consciousness. I would say, if you are sometimes Krishna conscious, it's a great blessing. Don't forget about steady. So you should understand, maybe I am not able to steady in Krishna consciousness, but I am talking about being in Krishna consciousness. That means I have experienced something. Be in that Krishna consciousness. So it's a stage. So the sadhana bhakti is a stage where we constantly associate with Krishna in his different forms, in devotional service into respective forms. Seva of the deities, seva of the spiritual master, seva of the devotees, seva of the holy name, seva of the prasadam. So we do all this association by seva. And we become steady in our Krishna consciousness. It's a direct process. Prabhupada always gives the example of Krishna consciousness. It's like going in a lift. Whereas going through all the other processes is just like, you know, going up the staircase. So Krishna consciousness, and that's also, that going up the staircase is called Pravritti Marga, and going in the lift is called Nivritti Marga. So that is the reason why when we are performing Sankirtana, when we are part of the Sankirtana movement, we don't give so much value to all these karmakandic restrictions.
If devotion service has to be done, we will do devotion service. Even if it means it is not according to the Vedic understanding, favorable, all those things. No. We just go ahead and do it. Because that is the most important thing. Because that is the purpose of all the Vedas. To serve Krishna is the purpose of the Vedas. Vedesya sarve rahameva vedya. So, that is the reason why we do not introduce lot of all these Vedic rituals. Even if we do Homa, we do Narsimha Homa, we do Homa for initiation, Vaishnava Homa, Narsimha Homa. The Homa, there are varieties of Homas. That's, you get into all those things, it's another forest of prescriptions in the Vedas, Homas. We stick to only the Vaishnava Homas. We chant Hare Krishna, Vaishnava mantras. Any questions?
Hare Krishna Prabhu. One of the qualities of a pure devotee is Daksha, expert. So Prabhupada, before going to Western world, when he, in the those decades, he was trying in India and attempts were not manifesting in form of the external results. So how to understand Prabhupada was still exhibiting the quality of expertness in a transcendental way?
Daksha, expert doesn't mean you have to get results. Whatever you do expertly. So why Daksha means you have to be successful. You are expert in the process. Whatever you are doing, you are expert in the process. The result is always in the hands of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That kind of daksha in the material world, expert, normally people mean you are expert means you are expert in producing results. But Vaishnavas are not after, they know results are not in our hands. The Supreme Lord is easy. So therefore, Prabhupada was Daksha. He was expert. What does expert mean? Basic thing here, Prabhupada's expertness was he was always Krishna conscious. He was trying to preach in India in different ways. He was in India and he was expert in performing his bhajan. It is his expertness in India where he stayed in Vrindavan and did his bhajan as witnessed by many witnesses that how intense he was in his japa, in his writing in Radha Damodar. So all that he did was, so short-sighted thinking should not be there, that if there is no result, there is no expertise. Daksha means he's expert in his work. Whatever best he can do, he will do in service of the Lord. Even there also, if there is some material mistakes, there is no material perfection. Just like Prabhupada writes in Srimad Bhagavatam introduction, even if so many mistakes are there, he quotes this sloka also. One should ignore those things, grammatical mistakes or this or that. One can say that grammatical mistake, that means he was not expert in language. Any other question?
Hey, sure. Prabhupada, I just heard that consciousness fluctuates and we are in one level of consciousness and we go up and down. But the objective, even if when we go to a higher level of consciousness, is to go more higher. The objective is to keep increasing our consciousness. So, is it that if you are in a level of consciousness and you think that in this life itself you want to achieve the highest level of consciousness, is it being fruitive? Or because basically our consciousness, I feel, dips down because we are fruitive in other things to get results. No, our consciousness dips down. So is it in the similar way to go to a higher level of consciousness, thinking about that and endeavoring for that, thinking about it, is it being fruitive? Or how to avoid, should we avoid and how to avoid?
No, you cannot avoid having a goal in life. Having a goal in life is not the meaning of fruitive. Fruitive means for fruits for sense gratification, gross and subtle sense gratification. That is fruit, a normal fruitive activity. Because originally we have a human being, a soul means he has desires. Desires for oneself is called fruitive. Desires for pleasing Krishna, that is called devotional service. And one of the items that pleases Krishna, the first thing that pleases Krishna, is if you become Krishna conscious. Therefore, you see, our desire to be Krishna conscious, our desire to elevate our consciousness, is not coming under the fruitive or selfishness. So our desire to be Krishna conscious is very pleasing to the Lord. What is it that, how can we please Krishna now? We are so impure, how can we please Krishna now? When we chant Hare Krishna also, how can we please Krishna? Krishna is very pleased by hearing you chant his name. The so purely you are chanting and so nicely you are serving the Nama, he is pleased by that? No. Just like a pure devotee who is uttering Krishna Nama, calling out to Krishna, it pleases Krishna directly. Now our chanting also pleases Krishna. But you should understand how it pleases Krishna. It pleases Krishna because the Lord, we are his part and parcel. So we are taking shelter of his name. We have taken shelter of sadhana bhakti. Just like how if your son is loitering in the world and finally the son decides that, okay, I have to go back to my parents, and then he takes a train which leads to the city where his parent is there. And the parents come to know of it. Are they happy? Because he is going to reach. Let's go and receive him. Train is going to arrive. He sat in the train already. And suppose somebody again now in some station he jumps away. Then again the Lord is not very happy. So just being in this train gives pleasure to Krishna. We are in the boat of Srila Prabhupada. We follow the boat, follow the captain of the boat. So as long as we follow the instruction of Srila Prabhupada, whether the act itself is directly giving pleasure, quality of pleasure, spiritual pleasure, because we are not chanting Shuddha Nama, how can we give that quality of pleasure? If you want Krishna to be pleased by your chanting, then you have to chant with your spiritual tongue and spiritual mind. Then that chanting is directly pleasing to him. Now the pleasing is you are pleasing the instruction of, you are pleasing the spiritual master. So therefore when we say, because often devotees say, we chant Hare Krishna, we do devotional service to please Krishna, we say. And then we tend to think, okay, is this directly pleasing Krishna? Is Krishna smiling? Is giving me a smile because I did this? That's not the level of our devotional service. Our level of devotional service is pleased with our following the instructions of Srila Prabhupada, and is pleased with us because We are staying in this train. We are sitting in the boat. We are not jumping out of the boat back into the samsara. So the body of instructions of Srila Prabhupada, that is a boat. And he is a captain, means this boat is made up of his instructions. So if our life is immersed every moment in the instruction of Srila Prabhupada, we are in this boat. So being in this boat pleases Krishna. Various instructions being followed. So it's a fact that Krishna is pleased, whether directly or indirectly, Krishna's pleasure is pleasure. But one should know what is the quality of how we are pleasing. How we are pleasing the Lord. So directly, sadhaka directly pleasing the Lord by his, a sadhaka pleasing the Lord by his very activities, which is pleasurable to the Lord, is only for a pure devotee. Any other question?
Harish, second question is, can I ask? Bro, this last class you were saying that while rendering service, one must uninterruptedly associate with Nama. But
one must
uninterruptedly associate with holy name. So, but practically when we apply this, how do we apply this is the thing. So, if say suppose you're rendering some service and then you're chanting, it may sometimes disturb the service. So,
that is why to feel concretely the pleasure in devotion service, pleasure of the Lord in devotion service, one has to think of pleasing Guru and Krishna. Then it is realistic. If you try to think that this, then what happens? Then immediately you will understand, yeah, Prabhupada is pleased. Because Prabhupada has done what all pleases him. So, pleasing Krishna directly, that concept is a little difficult. Unless one has got the idea. Of course, when we talk, normally we say pleasing Krishna, Krishna. But Krishna means Guru Krishna for a disciple. Devotion service to Krishna means devotion service to Guru and Krishna. So, when that understanding is there, then it becomes very realistic. So we can concretely feel you are doing something. Let's say you are doing preaching. What did Prabhupada say about that? Oh yes, I know Prabhupada like this. Well, let's say I build a temple. Then Prabhupada like this. Or I go out and distribute a book. Prabhupada likes it. Therefore Krishna likes it. So you can feel the pleasure of Guru more than trying to see the pleasure of Krishna. Pleasure of Guru is pleasure of Krishna. Yasya prasadat, bhagavat prasadat. So that, if you go directly to Krishna, then all these things will only be, you will not feel concreteness. How do I know Krishna is pleased? Easier to know how Prabhupada is pleased. Easier to know. Rendrachimat Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.